There is only one thing standing in the way between you and skyrocketing your company's revenue online, and it is not writing the latest and greatest Facebook ad or Google ad. I've been in digital marketing for 15 years, guys. My name is Justin Gross. I have worked with companies large and small, up to as big as Procter & Gamble and Johnson & Johnson. And one thing I've learned over the years is, well, yes, of course, you know, the traffic you're sending to your website, obviously that's a component of things. But really, the greatest mistake that I see companies make is not carefully optimizing the user experience, the post-click user experience. You have to look at that, and you have to look at that in a methodical way, right? You can't just, all right, so for those of you who have done some optimization, conversion rate optimization, landing page optimization, and things like that, looking at your UX, looking at your user experience, congratulations if you have actually examined this and gone down this road a bit. But you have to have a methodology. And if you've gotten to the point where you realize how important this is, but you don't have the right methodology, let's talk about that real quick. What are the components of a proper testing and optimization methodology for your website? All right, well, number one, how do you know what changes you need to make? You know you need to make changes. You know the changes to your content, your website, and user experience are gonna increase your conversion rates and increase your profitability. But how do you identify what are the most important changes to make? And for that matter, how do you identify what's actually gonna cause a conversion rate improvement versus not? And while the obvious answer may be testing, and that's true, yes, you need to do your testing, very, very true. There's a step you need to look at before you do any testing, and that's data collection, right? So now you're gonna look at data collection. You have to determine, you have to have scientific metrics in front of you and data points to guide you in the right direction. You have to have data that's gonna drive creation of a hypothesis that you're then gonna test, right? So what tools can you, and tools and processes can you implement to collect that data? So glad you asked. There are about three key processes that I like to implement to collect the data needed to launch a testing testing campaign. Number one are user tests. You want to hire external folks on platforms like usertesting.com. No, I'm not an affiliate of the platform. I just, you know, it's one of many tools I've used in the past. You want to get people to evaluate your website, provide honest feedback about the website, things that can be improved. You could ask some specific questions about specific things that you need answers to. Number two, you want to run heat maps and click tracking on your website. You want to see where people are scrolling, where they're clicking, and there aren't elements on the page, so on and so forth. And the third thing you want to do is you want to do Google Analytics auditing, or if you're using Adobe Analytics, whatever analytics tool you happen to be using. 95% of businesses are using Google Analytics, so we'll just assume you probably are using GA. You want to do a deep analytics audit, and you need to make sure your analytics are properly set up to track goals so you're actually able to get the right data out of your Google Analytics. Anyway, guys, you want to look at all those different tools to compile all the data you need. From there, you're going to have a good picture of the things you need to start testing. Hope that's helpful, guys. I'll see you on the next video and talk to you soon.